In the rolling hills of Montalcino, Tuscany, a harmonious combination of temperate climate and fertile soil has long helped create some of the finest wines in the world. But at this vineyard, the Paradiso di Frassina, there's another peculiar ingredient. For 7 days a week and 24 hours a day, these Sangiovese grapes are fed a steady diet of Mozart. The man behind this unorthodox approach is owner Carlo Cignozzi, a former musician.
I knew that music provides energy to the human soul. People need it to thrive. Plants are the same.
But could Mozart's Divertimento in D really produce a bacchanalia? Cignozzi says the vines closest to the speakers produce the juiciest grapes and the greenest leaves. He doesn't have to use much fertilizer or any pesticides. Mozart, he says, drives away the pests.
Crickets mate on the vine. That's why they make that sound. It's their mating call.
Yeah, tell me about this. I mean, why does the music scare away the crickets?
Because the cricket sings a serenade. I'm here, my love, I'm coming. But if Mozart music is playing, the female can't hear it. So they leave and go somewhere more quiet, to my neighbor's vineyard instead. The same thing happens with birds and wild boars that would otherwise eat my grapes.
Mozart wine. That sounds like a nice idea, but is it a gimmick? Well, now some researchers say there may be some veritas in that eccentric viticulture.
Scientists at the CREA Research Laboratory in Tuscany are trying to verify some of those claims.
Prior research shows that there is a positive impact on plant growth, as well as insects, when certain sound waves act as a deterrent for pests.
He also speculates that Mozart music mimics the frequencies of running water, which might explain why the grapevines stretch and grow towards the speakers. Now, Storchi and his team are trying to verify yet another potential benefit.
Yes, now I'm going to cut a leaf.
To see if music prevents the growth of fungus.
So you're looking for the right wavelength that's going to keep this plant from getting an infection.
Yes.
People have long considered plants to be lower life forms than humans. It was Aristotle who said that plants are on the edge between living and non-living. And in the Old Testament, Noah made room on the ark for the animals, not the plants. But today, there's a movement in science to recognize plants as sensitive and even sentient creatures.
Because plants are not just able to live, they are able to sense. They are much more sophisticated in sensing than animals.
Stefano Mancuso from the University of Florence, seen here giving a TED talk, is one more scientist studying Cignozzi's musical vineyard in depth.
And they are also able to show and to exhibit such a wonderful and complex behavior that can be described just with the term of intelligence.
Of course, there are skeptics.
Does anyone ever call you crazy? Nessuno ti ha mai detto, ma sei matto.
Sì.
Sure, the Italians are the worst. It's like hitting a wall. They tell me, Carlo, don't mess with wine.
But among the believers, Cignozzi also counts Bose, the high-end speaker producer. The company has sponsored his 120-speaker sound system, stretching 25 acres. And even inside his cellar, where resident winemaster Federico Ricci speculates the musical vibrations help with the fermentation process inside these barrels of prized Brunello, much in the way that swirling wine in the glass can unlock its most subtle flavors.
Allora, il vino che viene dal...
It's certainly very different. It has different chemical characteristics. It has many more polyphenols inside. Polyphenols give color to wine, as well as all those antioxidants that give it body. So this definitely makes a better wine.
But does the music have to be Mozart? Scientists say it could be anything, from the Rolling Stones to Barry White. But Cignozzi disagrees. He can't get enough of Mozart.
Gregorian song.
I've tried a variety, like Gregorian chants, but for me, Mozart is the composer of nature. It's the most geometric, the most profound, the most cheerful, yet the most mysterious. Such is Mozart. Such is my wine as well.
For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Christopher Livesay in Montalcino, Tuscany.